Good morning, everyone. You're watching live daily market outlook from the brokers. Today is Thursday, 15th of August 2013. The dollar is slightly softer against the majors at the beginning of today's trading, with one of the reasons being more positive data coming from Eurozone, as well as yesterday's release from UK with the jobs data beating the forecast. Leading investors to come out of the dollar and move in the other currencies at the beginning of European session that is partially closed due to today's holidays in a number of European countries. Euro reached the fresh high of the session at 133.10, at cracking the psychological 133 barrier. Sterling holds steady above 155 following yesterday's rally upon the release of better than expected data, while dollar yen is in defense and the fresh session low was reached at 97.57, currently holding around the 97.80 level. Aussie dollar holds a firm tone off recent low at 90.72, so far having regained the 91.82 on the corrective action of 90.72, still under its recent peak at 92.20 that capped the recovery action. From commodities, gold is steady. During the session, the yellow metal reached 1345 level, still unable to clear our key barrier at 1347, but holding steady according to the near-term technicals. With the crude oil being in the range mode in the past since I do apologize, heading higher. I just had the wrong chart in front of me. Heading higher with the fresh session high seen at 107.36 as a part of the broader recovery from 102.22. Of course, we are going to elaborate technicals in a while in details. A quick look at today's calendars that again doesn't lack data. As said, most of European countries are closed for the holiday, but we have 8:30 release of UK's retail sales set for July. 0.7% is the forecast, well above June's 0.2%. America's give us more data, economic indicators today. Inflation from America is due, from United States, pardon, is due at 12:30 GMT, July's release. Monthly release is forecasted at 0.2% versus 0.5% in June, while core CPI for July is expected to stay unchanged at 0.2%. Unemployment claims as today's Thursday weekly release, 334,000 new claims in the past week, just 1,000 above previous week's 333,000. Empire State Manufacturing Index for August, 10.2 is the forecast, above July's release at 9.5. Capacity utilization due at 13.15 GMT, July's release 77.9%, slightly above June's 77.8%, while industrial production for July is expected to pick up by 0.5% compared to 0.3% in the month of June. Philadelphia Fed Manufacturing Index for July is forecasted below June's release of 19.8. 15.6 is today's consensus, and the housing market index for August due at 1400 GMT is expected to stay unchanged at 57. These are the highlights from today's calendar. As we can see, the Europe is mainly out from today's releases, with the focus seen in the later in the day when America opens. Most of indicators are due to be released from United States for today, 15th of August 2013. Now we're going to take a look at technicals and see what we can expect from the major currencies and commodities for today. As said, the euro is in the corrective consolidative mode, I would say rather corrective of a recent peak at 133.99. This is according to the 4-hour chart. As dips reached so far 132.32, where the temporary support was found, but 4-hour structure is still negative and still keeps more focused to the downside. We have a bounce of 132, where the double bottom attempt is now seen, with gains reaching 133.10 so far, making a more positive hourly structure as the price reached levels above 133. That marks approximately above, pardon, psychological 133 level, close to our next important target, top of yesterday 133.15. That also marks 50% retracement of the downleg from 133.99 to 132.32. And basically, we need to see a clear break above this level in order to shift focus higher, with the near-term hourly structure still being positive, though we have RSI now moving lower, while strong momentum is still present and still sees scope for a possible fresh extension higher. The price holds above 20.55 days moving averages, now attempting at 10 days one. That already crossed above both larger moving averages and holding above initial support. That was the previous consolidation range top at 132.78, where the price came right now. Would keep focus at the upside, of course, as I said, break above 133.15 as initial seen as initial requirement in order to possibly resume recovery and confirm the double bottom formation at 132.32 and 132.38 in order to reattract upper targets. As set on the 4-hour chart, pardon, on the 4-hour chart, still weak studies keep downside vulnerable, with the possible break below 132 and 132.32 base and 132 as psychological support. Would see an increased downside risk towards the higher platform at 131.80 zone, a break of which to confirm the near-term corrective action underway and open way for a deeper pullback. On the daily, the positive tone is still present, though lacking momentum at this point, following upside rejection at 133.99, just ahead of our target at 134.14. Still positive tone prevails and still sees more upside potential. I would say downside risk would increase on the break above, would break below 131.80 higher platform and 55 days moving average at 131.70. That reinforces the support, as well as 131.53, 38.2% retracement. Now comes 200 days moving average, that is currently, it's along with the 90 days, around 131. So break below this level is to confirm a lower top, a marginally lower top at 133.99, and allow for a further easing towards the downside. But so far, positive tone that prevails is still more scope towards the upside, as long as we are holding above 132.32 and 131.80 supports. The British pound gained traction yesterday following release of better-than-expected data and attempting again through the 200-day moving average. So far, there is no clear break above this level, currently standing at 155.22, but a positive tone established from yesterday with the closing in green. 154.98 was yesterday's closing price, just around the psychological 155 support, still holds focus at the upside, with notion being supported by positive daily studies. Now, on the lower time frames, positive tone prevails on the hourly chart, following yesterday's strong rally and bounce from 154.20, where the basing attempt is now evident. As the price bounced so far to 155.45 and retraced over 76.4% of the downleg from 155.73 down to 154.20. Corrective pullback seen late yesterday was capped at, was, pardon, contained at 154.95. As I said, 155 offers quite good support. This also marks midpoint of the entire downleg from 155.73, and holding above this level keeps focus at the upside. We need to see the break above our initial barrier at 155.45, yesterday's high, in order to open the way towards interim barrier at 155.57 9th of August high and for final push towards 155.73 8th of August peak. On the 4 hour chart, the positive tone is still present as indicators now move above their midlines, with downside being well protected at 154.20. This is the higher low and higher base, reinforced by ascending 55 days moving averages, seeing potential for further extension higher of the outlook from 151 2nd of August low, as well as larger uptrend that commenced from 148.12 a low of 9th of July 2013, as daily studies remain positive. We did see a clear break above 200 days moving average and the clearance of 155.73 peak in order to resume the recovery. The main bull trend line drawn of 148.12 and going through 151 so far stands at around 152.90 and the supports the downside, along with the bullish crossovers of daily 20 days moving average through 100 days and 55 days, supporting the current price action for a possible final push towards our key barrier at 157.51. This is the peak of 17th of June 2013 and seen as a short-term target, of course, requirements set a clear break above 200 days moving average and the 155.73 peak. Alternative scenarios is increased downside risk on a penetration through 154.20. This is the pivotal point, as we have the previous high at 154.33, a break of which to face moving averages 20, 55 and 100 days. Initially 153.71, 153.44 and 153.22 ahead of 152, approximately 80.90, where is the bull trend line, and also midpoint of the down leg from 157.51 to 148.12. Dollar yen, as said, is in defensive mode today, following an extension of the recovery rally from 95.78 to 98.41, where the gains were capped and the price pulled back down to 97.57 so far. On the hourly chart, indicators turn into the negative territory following a pullback lower, but still this could be seen as a corrective action as the price is attempting to leave a higher low at 97.57 on a current bounce that currently attempts through 20 days moving average at 97.93. Currently, basically break above psychological 98 barrier is to open a minor barrier at 98.28 and our more important 98.41, break of which to resume the recovery rally from 95.78. This is the low of 8th of August 2013. Now on the 4 hour chart, positive tone prevails, though extended the conditions triggered this pullback, the downside so far being contained by 20 and 55 days moving averages. Both are moving sideways at this point. We need to see more extension higher in order to start ascending again. That will be more supportive for the pair, as the price so far retraced 61.8% of the downleg, larger downleg from 99.93 to 95.78. On the 4 hour set, still more focus towards the upside. As long as we hold above our initial support at 97.57, loss of this level in the near term would have a more negative impact to the pair, as the larger a larger picture still keeps a negative tone, as the price action is entrenched within the bear channel that was already cracked on the extension lower down to 95.78. We're talking about downleg that commenced from 101.52 peak of 8th of July 2013, with the 20 days, daily 20 days moving average so far capping the upside, above which we have 100 days, one at 98.77, and the channel resistance, bear trend line, 99.47. in case of penetration of the trend line and a lower top at 99.93, which is close to psychological 100 barrier, and then we could be talking about confirmation of the base at 95.78 and shifting focus again towards the upper targets where there is 100.85 and the 101.52 hour key near-term resistance. Except the negative tone that prevails on the daily chart still keeps the downside vulnerable. From the other side, the negative weak structure of the hourly chart again keeps the downside focused. Overall, more risk is still seen towards the downside as the dollar is in defensive mode, as we mentioned at the beginning of the our today's session. And according to the fundamentals that are dollar negative, I would say that more risk is seen towards the downside, of course, with technicals as a number one indicator supporting the notion, unless the price breaks above our initial target 98.41, that would bring a more positive tone into the near-term structure. And finally, from the major pairs, Aussie dollar. Daily tone is still negative as a part of the larger downtrend, but the pair is currently in the corrective mode of 88.46 low of 5th of August, attempting to complete daily cup and holder pattern, pardon, with the holder now being underway. We need to see the break above 92.20 that capped the recent corrective action of 88.46 in order to complete the pattern that is a reversal pattern, and that would be a signal for possible stronger corrective action. Of course, on the upside, we have a more significant barriers, 93.16 peak of 24th of July, and the 93.43 26th of June high. Basically, these are the congestion tops of the previous sideways, previous consolidation phase, and the break above these levels is required to open way for some stronger corrective action. If you take a look at the down leg that commenced from 96.64, this is somewhere between 50 and 61.8% retracement, and the break above these levels is seen as a minimum requirement to confirm the near-term base and allow for some stronger corrective action. As set, 92.20 is our initial resistance above which we have descending 55 days moving average at 92.45 currently, along with the 50% retracement at 92.55. So quite strong barriers ahead, but completion of the cup and holder pattern on the daily chart would signal some more significant corrective action. Now on the 4 hour positive tone still exists, though the price is lacking momentum at this point on approach to our initial target and barrier at 92.20, and any failure to break here would see prolonged consolidation as long as the price holds above 90.72 low of 2 days ago, 13th of August, with the downside so far, where the downside was protected by 55 days moving average of the 4 hour chart. Now finally, the hourly structure shows a positive tone prevailing off recent low at 90.72 as the price ascends and holds above all three moving averages, with indicators being positively aligned, seeing potential for extension and the final push through 92.20 barrier. Set levels to watch in near term, 90.72 on the downside and the 92.20 on the upside. Of course, more significant are above 93.16, 93.43 break, of which is to confirm the larger picture corrective action, while in the near term, a break above 92.20 is required to open 93 barrier and further targets at the upside. We have a request for Kiwi dollar. Let's take a quick look since we are in the currencies, if we do have it. Yes. Let's just take a quick look on the daily chart. Positive tone is still present as the price action is moving upwards of 77.35. This is the low of 5th of August. Coming just ahead of our key near-term target, 81.04, 25th of July peak, just and also ahead of the next significant barrier, 81.35, 14th of June, high and 50% retracement of the downleg from 85.84 down to 76.86. This is the low of 30th of June 2013. Still positive tone seen on the daily chart. Of course, we need to see the extension through 81.04 as our initial barrier in order to confirm the resumption of the recovery rally from 76.86. On the Ichimoku studies, again, quite interesting situation. Positive tone is evident. The price is still within the cloud, and the 81.33 is the cloud top. I think it's close to 81.35. Okay, this is reinforcing our strong barrier at 81.35. So we have the previous peak, 50% retracement, and the daily cloud top at 81.35 zone break, of which to signal a near-term base that was established at around the 76.80 zone to allow for stronger corrective action of the larger descent. I think we see it better, or of the larger descent that commenced from 85. 84, and now the bottoming is evident, more requirements in the upside, 81, 81.35, and then we have also the 200 days moving average currently at 82.09. So the main near-term focus is seen at 81, 81.35. If we see the break above these levels, then we can talk about more significant corrective action. On the four-hour chart, the positive tone is present still, and the sees potential for a final push through 81.04 and the resumption of the recovery rally from 77.35, the higher low towards 81.35, our next target, with the hourlies being positive. Now the overbought conditions could signal pause in the current rally that approaches 81.04. On the downside, immediate support is the 80.55. Then we have the higher low at 80.17, 80.00 as a psychological support. Below, above this is 12.55 days moving average. I would say holding above 80, that is approximately midpoint of the current rally, if I'm not mistaken, exactly there. We can still keep the positive near-term positive tone in play. Any violation of 80 psychological support would again shift focus, near-term focus towards the downside. And finally, we're a bit short with the time. Let's just have a quick look at gold. Positive tone prevails on the lower time frames. Hourly structure is positive, though the overbought conditions now suggest pause in the current rally that came to 13.46, just ahead of our initial target at 13.47, with the price now emerging out of the daily cloud. Top is at 13.34, acting as initial support. If you see the clear break above 13.47, then we can talk about more significant corrective action, extension, pardon, of the corrective action of 1180 low of 28th of June, that so far retraced nearly 61.8%, pardon, over 61.8% of the latest downleg from 1423 down to 1180. 1330 was the 61.8%. Now the next target comes at 1366, that is 76.4% Fibonacci retracement, and the price actually being supported by ascending bull trend line, tentative one from 1180 through 1272 higher low, currently standing at approximately 1300, reinforcing psychological 1300 support. As I said, this is also the midpoint of the entire downleg from 1423 to 1180. Any slide below 1300 would be bearish, otherwise a positive tone that prevails still sees more potential towards the upside. Of course, break above 1347 is seen as a minimum requirement to resume the recovery rally of 1180 open. The next target 1366, then we have 1394 high of 13th of June. Of course, 1400 as psychological support comes next. That will be all for today. If we don't have any further questions, I would like then to conclude today's session and leave some space for our colleagues that will continue with the Arabic daily market outlook. Thank you for being with us, and expect to see you again tomorrow morning. That will be the last day of this week. Stay with us. Our next session comes at the same time, 7 o'clock GMT, 10 o'clock local Cyprus time. Wish you a nice Thursday, and of course, a lot of success and the profits in your trading. Good luck.